गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, दिस इज़ अवर फिफ्थ लेक्चर ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर मार्केटिंग ट्रेड एंड प्राइसेस, दैट इज इकॉन 353. सो अवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट मार्केटिंग फंक्शंस. एज वी नो, मार्केटिंग इज अ प्रोसेस व्हिच स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम पॉइंट ऑफ प्रोडक्शन टू द पॉइंट ऑफ कंजम्पशन, मीन्स फ्रॉम द फार्मर्स फील्ड टू द कंज्यूमर, अल्टीमेट कंज्यूमर. सो टुडे वी हैव टू सी different marketing functions. It may include transportation, storage, processing, standardization, grading, and even market information also. So market function, it is any single activity performed in carrying a product from the point of its production to the ultimate consumer may be termed as a marketing function. So these marketing functions are classified by different economists. So firstly, it is classified by Thomson. Thomson classified marketing function in three types, that is primary function, secondary function and tertiary function. In primary function, they have involved assembling and procurement of the products, then processing, and third one, dispersion or distribution. These are the primary functions. Then secondary function, according to Thomson's, are packing or packaging, transportation, grading, standardization and quality control aspects, then storage and warehousing, price determination or price discovery, risk taking, financing, buying and selling, demand creation, dissemination of market information. These are the secondary. And according to Thomson, in tertiary functions are banking, insurance, communication, supply of energy or electricity. So these are the three types of marketing function according to the Thomson. Now, most important, the question was asked mostly on Kohl's and Wool's classification of marketing functions. So economists Kohl's and Wool's, they have classified marketing functions in three ways, that is physical function, exchange function, and third one, facilitative functions. Physical function, which involves storage and warehousing, grading, processing, transportation. Then exchange function involves buying and selling, whereas facilitative function involves standardization of grades, financing, risk taking, dissemination of market information. So this is about the Thomson's and Kohl's and Wool's classification of marketing function. Next is Huge and Mitchell classification of marketing functions. According to him, they have classified marketing function into three ways, and that is physical movement function, ownership movement function, and market management function. In physical movement function, as we know, storage, packaging, transportation, grading, distribution, these are the physical movement function. Second one is ownership movement function, that is buying, selling, determination need, creating demand, finding buyers and sellers, negotiation of price, rendering advice, transferring from the title of goods. Then next, market management function. It may involve formulating policies, different policies for marketing functioning of market, financing, providing organization, supervision, accounting, securing information. These are the classification given by the different economists. So now we will see different marketing functions. In that, first one, packing. What is packing or packaging? It is wrapping of the goods by any material to avoid the wear and tear. This is the packaging. What are the different advantages of packing and packaging? As we know, different advantages of packing and packaging. We get a better price. We can wrap, or we can do the advertisement through the packing or packaging material. We can avoid the wear and tear of the product through packing and packaging. So these are some advantages of packing and packaging. The next function is most important, that is transportation. Transportation occupies 50% cost of marketing. It requires maximum cost in all the marketing functions. So transportation means moving the goods from the point of production to the market. It may involve road transport, air transport, or water transport, that is seaboat. Okay, Now, what are the different advantages of transport function? Widening of market means we can move from one market to another market. We can extend the market. Then narrowing price difference over space. Creation of employment through transport function. We can create the employment. Facilitation of specialized farming. Transformation of the economy. Mobility of the factors of production. These are the some advantages of transportation function. Now, what is transportation cost? The cost required for movement of goods from the point of production to the point of consumption or up to the market, that is a transportation cost. It occupies 50% of total marketing cost. It is the maximum cost. Now, which factors affect the transportation cost? These are the distance. Obviously, distance is the main factor which may affect the transportation cost. Then quantity of the product, mode of transportation, condition of roads, nature of products, availability of return journey, consignment, then risk associated with the transportation. These are the some factors which affect the transportation cost. Now, which are the problems in transportation of agricultural commodities? As we know, agriculture commodities, they are bulky in nature, so there are so many problems in the transportation of agricultural commodities. The next is grading and standardization. So what is grading and standardization? So standardization is the determination of basic limits or grades or the establishment of model processes and methods of producing, handling and selling goods and services. This is a standardization. So we have to fix one standard. Then grading, it is the sorting of unlike lots of the produce into different lots according to their quality specification or according to their characteristics. That is a grading. Now, what are the types of grading? It may be fixed grading, mandatory grading, then second, permissive grading, variable grading, third, centralized grading or decentralized grading. These are the different types of grading. And next, what are the advantages of grading? Grading, it is advantageous to producers as well as to the consumers also, because producer, they will get the good price for their good quality products, and consumer, they will get the good quality products according to different grades. Okay, then next. Products, they are seasonal, they are perishable, so their keeping quality or their keeping period is very less. So if you want to store agriculture products, we need a storage facilities. Now, what are the risks in storage? That is quality loss, obviously. Then quantity loss, quality deterioration and price risk. These are the three risks in storage. Next is processing. What is processing? Processing is change in form, means from raw material to the product. That is the processing. Okay. Now, what are the advantages of processing? Through processing, we can add the value to that product. Okay. These are the advantages of processing function. Now, next is buying and selling. But what is buying and selling? It is a transaction or exchange of goods with the money. Now, what are the different methods of buying and selling? This is the most important topic. Under cover of cloth, that is hatta system. Then second, private negotiation. Third, quotation on samples taken by the commission agent. Dhara sale method, mogam sale method, and most important is open auction method. In open auction method, there are another three methods, that is Pahar system of open auction, random bid system of open auction, roster bid system of open auction, and last method of buying and selling is closed tender system. So, under cover up cloth system means the sellers, they sit on a particular place, and under cover up cloth they press the fingers according to, these are the some symbols, with that symbol they fix the price. that is the under cover of cloth or hatta system. Then private negotiation means middleman, he will do the negotiation between two sellers, that is private negotiation. Quotation on sample taken by commission agents, then commission agent fix the some quotation on the sample. This is also then dara sale method. Dara sale method is used in for cumin, jeera, for selling and buying of the jeera. Then mogam sale method, open auction method and close tender method. Next is our last topic of today's lecture is market information. So what is market information? It is a knowledge or it is information about the market. It communication or reception of knowledge or intelligence. It may include facts, estimations, opinions and other information which affect the marketing functions or which affect the marketing of goods and services. Now what are the different types of market information? These are the three types. First one, market intelligence, which is based on historical data, last year data. Then market news, it is based on current data. And market outlook means these are the predictions for the future. These are the three main types of market information. Now what will be the criteria of good market information? It may be that market information must be comprehensive. It may include all the information or the overall information. Next, accuracy. That information must be accurate and clear. Then relevance. That information must be relevance or related to the market or actual market conditions. Then confidentiality. That information must be confidential before publication. It must be confidential or secret before the publication of the information. Then trustworthy. It must be trustworthy to the farmer, producer or any market middleman or any market agencies. Then equal and easy to assessable. That market information must be equal for all and it must be easy to assess. And last, timeliness. That market information must be timely available, must be time specific. Now last, financing. According to great economist Paile, money or credit is the lubricant that facilitate the marketing machine. So for functioning of the all the marketing agencies, we need the financial support. So money is the lubricant that facilitate the marketing machine. Now which are the factors affecting capital requirement of agricultural marketing firm? There are different factors. First one, nature and volume of business, necessity of carrying large stocks, continuity of business during various seasons, then time required between production and sale, terms of payment for purchase and sale, fluctuation in prices, risk taking capacity, and last one, general conditions in the economy. These are the some factors which affects the capital requirement or financial requirement of agricultural marketing system. Okay, then last, NABARD in agriculture marketing finance. What is the role of NABARD in agriculture finance? It is the National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development. It is an apex organization in the sphere of rural finance. They give some financial support to the producers. This is all about our today's lecture on different marketing functions. Thank you.